Hello and welcome back. Okay, guys, last night I picked this Cava Peaks, and you guys know me well enough to know that, or if you guys have been watching my channel long enough, you guys would know that I'm all about making restoring locks and or improving them. So I couldn't put this thing back together without making it right. So, it last night I picked it. It didn't have a check pin, so you'll notice that when I put the key in, it was missing the first pin, which is that check pin. So after watching a couple videos, because there's only a couple of them, there's only three other videos where somebody guts one of these. I did some pretty good study of what the pin looks like, as well as whether there was a spring in that chamber in the Bible, and and by the way, it is a lot smaller. A lot. I don't know if you guys can see this. I don't know if my camera's picking it up. But it's almost like it's undercut right there, and the pin that falls down in to go flush with the cut on the key, which by the way is all the way to the top on this key especially. It's undercut, or it's anyways, it's undercut right there, so it falls down into that, and so the pin that actually touches the key is tiny. I mean, absolutely tiny. So here is the pin, the check pin that I made for this, and let me show you the size of the smallest key pin. Which, for those of you who know what size key pins are, this is a 165B. This is the smallest key pin that I own compared to the check pin that I made to go in there. I don't even know if if my camera will pick this up very well, but there's a comparison in size. Absolutely tiny. I mean, just the tiniest pin you could ever imagine. But that, my friend, is what actually fits in there. And when you put the key in, is what makes it flush. So, without the key, you'll notice that the pin drops back down. Everything in this lock is like super, super tight because of the tolerances. But now you can see that there is definitely a space in between that pin for the check pin. And then when you put the key in, it does go to flush. So I have successfully made a check pin for this Cava Peaks. Now, you'll also notice that on the front of that, if this my camera's picking it up, that first pin, because of the ledge here, doesn't fit right. So to put this back together, I am going to shim it and pray a lot that I can get this back together without having too many issues. So this is the moment of truth, guys, to find out whether or not I have successfully made a check pin for this key for this Cava lock. Okay, I think we're all the way through. Okay, we're all the way in, and the key works smooth. So I'm going to put the clip back on the back, which I just did, pull the key out, and it is locked, and the key works smoothly. So I have restored this Cava Peaks to its somewhat original state. It now has a check pin that works. And so the next picker that I send this to will have to deal with the check pin and the nasty warning and the tight tolerances. So hope this video was interesting. Thank you for your time. Thank you for watching, and don't break the law.